Well, guess what, folks? I have here a massive box of WADA Returns. I think there are maybe 7 or so games in here. I have not looked at them. I'm gonna open them up for you guys. You can get my live reaction. And then I'm gonna talk about something that I don't hear people discussing a whole lot in the graded game world that I've learned over the course of grading, I don't know, probably 50, 60, maybe up to 100 games that I think will hopefully be helpful to you guys. So let's go ahead and open these first. The first one we have here, ooh, looks like a Game Boy Advance game. I'm gonna try to cover up, yeah, there we go. Ooh, Final Fantasy V Advance. This box, I think, was in really solid shape. I'd love to get a pretty high grade on this. Let's see. Let's go. 9.6 A+ on this guy, folks. That is an amazing grade, especially for a box game. I will take that any day of the week. I don't actually remember where I got that first one. Okay, another Final Fantasy game here. We've got Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. Not like the rarest boxed game, I don't believe, Game Boy Advance game, but let's see the grade we got. Let's go, 9.6 A+. Again, I will take that any day. I wish that I could tell you guys what these games actually, what I purchased them for, but to be honest, I don't really remember. Up next, we've got, oh, interesting. So they left the sticker on this, the Sears sticker. I don't know if you have to like designate in the comments maybe to take the sticker off. I do know that it won't affect the grade. They grade the seal beneath the sticker independently of the actual sticker. So you can see it was originally $35 there at Sears. And the grade they gave was, interesting, a 9.6 B seal rating. So the seal must have had some pretty serious flaws for them to give it that rating. Surely it's not that bad, oh my gosh. Wow, I do not know why I sent this in. Maybe it was just an experiment, because look at this. You guys can probably even see this on camera. On the edge there, there's just a massive tear right on the corner of the game. Holy cow, it spans, if you can't see it, from like here to here on the game, just missing plastic. So honestly, the fact this got a B is pretty impressive. I'm not even gonna complain about it. Oh dang, we've got another original PlayStation game here, Tomb Raider Chronicles. I don't think these games are uber rare in sealed condition, but you know, always nice to see. Nonetheless, we got a, oh folks, that is insane. A 9.8 A+ on this guy. That is fantastic. Really excited to see what the value ends up being on this one. And I think I will go ahead and look up like eBay solds or listed on as many of these as I can to give you guys an idea before this video is done. Next up, we've got Tomb Raider The Last Revelation. Apparently I got a load of sealed Tomb Raider games in at some point, and the grade we got is, okay, a 9.6 B+ on this one, so I'm guessing there were probably pretty significant seal issues on there. Yeah, there's just a hole, a straight up tear in the seal right there. So I think I sent these in largely just kind of as an experiment to see, get a better feel for the grading scale. And we have, guess what, another Tomb Raider revelation here, which is a 9.6 A. So not bad at all on that. All of these, at the time this is posted, should probably be on my eBay store if they haven't sold already, if any of you guys happen to be interested. Last but not least, let's take this one out of the bag. I don't really like the reflection that those bags give. Ooh, okay, so we have another PlayStation game. This one, oh, this is a big one, folks. This is the biggest one of the whole bin for sure. Capcom versus SNK Pro. And hopefully the seal, I don't see any major flaws on this, so I didn't really check the back. We'll see. Oh my goodness, folks, that is incredible. 9.8 A+, just about pretty close to the best grade you can possibly get on this PlayStation game. If I could have picked one of this whole batch to be a really high grade, it would have been this one. I'm absolutely tickled about that. All right, so here are all of our little gems from the day. I've taken the liberty of looking them all up on eBay. The first one, this Final Fantasy V, looks like the best comp that we have is right here at auction, 534. I would guess the strategy with a lot of these that went only at auction is going to be to list for maybe a few hundred higher with best offer and just kind of see what happens. This is actually a slightly better grade than that one as well. So that's great to see with that one. Probably will list it at, you know, 800 or so. The next one, Final Fantasy Tactics, 9.6 A+. The closest comp was sold in January, again at auction, for 780. So that's also also great to see. We'll probably list this in like the 1,000 range. Next up, we've got Tomb Raider 3 9.6B. There were no solds on this, but under listed, we do have three of them. And this one is a similar condition to mine, 9.6B plus, so a little bit better. So 525 is basically my price ceiling on this one. We've got two of these Tomb Raider Chronicles, really great grade on that one. None sold, but we do have a listing here of a 9.8 A plus for, again, 600. So that'll be my price ceiling for this game. And the other one got a much worse grade, so it'll definitely go for lower, probably more in the like 200 to 300 range. Last Revelation is not great news with that. 9.6B plus, this 9.4 A plus sold with bids for 207, so we're looking probably between 200 and 300 for this. Then Capcom SNK actually had no solds on eBay. There was one that sold in sealed condition for 400, so that's a good sign. So I went to price charting and checked the graded prices. The only record is a Heritage Auctions sold for $690, and the condition is slightly lower grade than this one. This is another one. Oftentimes there's a bit of a multiplier effect with like marginally higher grade. So I'm gonna list this one pretty high with best offer, especially because there are no other listings, probably in the 1200 plus range, and just kind of see what happens. But either way, I'm thrilled with the grade on this one. Now, here's what I don't hear people talking about enough in the graded game world, because you hear plenty of people on one side saying, you know, graded games bad, they should be opposed at all costs. And then you have like the, you know, WADA bros or the VGA bros who are like all about the VGA and the graded games. And like these things have amazing investment potential. And you know, these are financial assets, blah, 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 blah. What I don't hear a lot of people saying is that there are some kinds of graded games that in this last year have gone down in value a lot. So what I'm looking at mostly is the semi-recent disc-based game. So I'm talking Wii, I'm talking PS2, and especially like PS3, that kind of era. A lot of the prices on those were really high initially because there was just very limited supply. But as more and more supply is coming out of the grading facilities and into the hands of collectors and resellers, prices on a lot of stuff, like don't even get me started on like Mario Galaxy or Mario Galaxy 2. There are so many sealed copies out there and now so many graded copies. The prices on those have absolutely tanked this last year. I'm talking PlayStation 2 stuff like Armored Core 9 Breaker. This one is still listed and hasn't sold. I'm talking about Onimusha 2 on PS2 as well, which is still listed and hasn't sold. I'm talking, dare I say, even a lot of GameCube titles, which are more readily available in sealed condition and are not extremely expensive, going down in value as well. So just wanted to issue that word of warning. As much as possible, when you are considering whether or not to send a game into WADA or VGA or wherever, CGC if they're coming on the market at any point, make sure to check as long of a price history as you can. Get a feel for where the trend line is going. And if it's pointing, use a lot of caution because grading fees are like $100 a game. I will say a little bit of an update for you. Return times, at least through WADA, have been getting a lot better. Some of these games, granted, I sent in like September, August, like they've been there for a long time, but I'm seeing in the Discord, this is something that we're talking about a lot, is people are starting to get stuff back a lot quicker. I think their operations are getting a lot more established in California. They're starting to churn through stuff at a much more acceptable rate, I would say. Can't so far say the same for VGA, but granted, most of the people in the Discord tend to do WADA more. Also, WADA is now accepting all kinds of that like semi-recent, like they didn't used to do PS3, they're doing that now. They're doing a bunch of modern stuff. This is not in any way sponsored by WADA or VGA, just wanted to give you guys a little bit of an update there. But yeah, check out this over here is my list but unsold box of Doom, and you can see there's a lot of PS2 in here. Even one, we do have Mario Kart 64 in there, but that's because it's the Player's Choice Edition. Not the best decision on that. I actually have done pretty decent with Vita stuff. I wouldn't say quite as much. I think there's less of it sealed out there, but yeah, more GameCube in here. By the way, all these games are on my eBay store. If anyone is interested, you're welcome to shoot me offers, especially if you're a viewer, I'll try to make you a deal. Resident Evil even has not sold yet. I think I listed this at like 600 and it's just sitting there. All that to say, folks, use an abundance of caution in the graded game game. Don't just jump into it flippantly because it does cost a lot of money to get these things encased in plastic. And you want to be very certain that you're making a good investment and actually increasing the value of any given sealed game. To be completely honest, a lot of these here and a lot of these in my box of doom, I probably, if I could do it again, would just flip them in sealed condition, not have the wait time, not have that money tied up for so long, and just continue turning my money quickly. Make Mr. Krabs proud, everyone.